Masha's Tales.
No, no, no. Don't even try to make me. I won't play these music scales. And no, not because I'm lazy. It's just that... I'll tell you a fairy tale. Once upon a time...
Three little pigs.
Three brothers came to live near the magic forest in some faraway land. And these brothers were piglets. Their names were Boo Boo, Woo Hoo, and Oopsie Daisy. The Pig brothers loved to have fun, just like any other piggies. They would lie in the mud puddle or run through the forest scaring the animals. Or they would eat the acorns and leave nothing for the rest. All you could hear in the forest all day long was them running, squealing, and snorting. And the worst thing of all was that these pig brothers loved to play music. They found some musical instruments, a guitar, a drum, and a big shiny one. I'm not sure what they call it, but they always have them in the marching band. So anyway, as soon as the moon came out, the pig brothers would come out too and sit on the riverbank by the fire and hold their concert. They would sing very loudly and no one around them could sing. Pigs are the greatest and the best, tra-la-la, tra-la-la. Pigs are smarter than the rest, tra-la-la-la-la. The animals called the police. They protested and complained, but nothing worked. They couldn't get the pigs to stop making noise. Then summer ended, and autumn came to the magic forest. But the pigs were not afraid of the cold. Over the summer, they had put so much bacon on their bones, they could barely get into their houses. They squealed and squeezed through the door sideways. So the animals in the forest grew really sad. Winter was coming. They had to hibernate in their lairs. But how could they sleep with these piggy concerts blaring away? The animals grew sadder and sadder, but it's no use crying over spilt milk. After that, the animals gathered for an all-force meeting, and they started to think about how to make the pig brothers move out. They argued, they shouted. And finally, the animals decided to scare the pig brothers away. They dressed the sheep into the wolf's clothing and sent him off to scare away the pigs. So the sheep galloped up to the pigs' houses and bleated. Bah! The pig brothers looked out their window and they couldn't believe their eyes. Again, the sheep again to them. Bah! The pig brothers laughed so hard that two of their houses fell down. At first, the animals were happy. At least they'd gotten rid of two of the pig brothers. But that was not the case. Boo Boo and Woo Hoo got out from underneath their broken houses and moved in with their brother, Oopsie Daisy. So the three little pigs lived in a solid stone house, very comfortable. They sat by the window and sang their songs as loudly as ever. We are saying, come what may, tra-la-la, tra-la-la. You can't scare the pigs away, tra-la-la-la-la. Again, the animals gathered for another all-forest meeting. And this is what they decided. One early morning, after another one of the pigs' all-night concerts, when the pig brothers had just gotten to sleep, all the animals went over to the pig's house. The sheep stuck her nose through the window. The dog climbed over her back. A cat jumped over the dog, and the rooster landed on the cat's head. All the animals started to scream all at once. The dog said, meow! The cat said, cock-a-doodle-doo. The rooster said, woof, woof. And the sheep said, baa. Bad piggies, you'd better back out of here with your band. The three little pigs got so scared that they ran around the house and they fled in different directions. After that, there were no more troublemakers in the forest and everything was nice and quiet. That's what I'm telling you. You have to think of those who live next to you. And if you want to sing songs, dance, and play music, do it in special places called music halls. Please eat, my dear little toy friends. Even though you are not the newest of all my toys, you are my favorite ones. I'll tell you a good fairy tale now.
The Swineherd.
In a kingdom far, far away, lived this one princess who was very fussy. More than anything in the world, the princess loved mechanical toys, especially those that were very intricately made. In her palace, she had a mechanical nightingale, a jack-in-the-box, and an artificial rose that looked very realistic. In the neighboring kingdom, there lived a prince who was very kind and who really loved animals. This prince loved cats, dogs, horses, and even little piglets. The kingdom where the prince lived was not a very big one, but there was plenty of room for everyone, like a real zoo. One day, the prince took his pigs out into the meadow and saw the fussy princess with her ladies-in-waiting playing with the mechanical nightingale. Oh my, what a beautiful princess, thought the prince. I really should get her a nice present. The prince chose the pudgiest and pinkest piglet of all of them, and he sent it to the princess. He also sent her a letter with the piglet offering the princess his hand and heart. Oh my, what a lovely little piglet, the princess screamed. So pudgy and pink, it must have cost a fortune. Just listen to the sound it's making. It snorts almost like a real piglet. Ew, said the ladies-in-waiting. That's because it is a real pig. What? It is not a toy, said the princess, and blinked her eyes, looking hurt. This prince can take his pig along with his hand and his heart and stay far away from my palace. How dare you treat me, a princess, like a pig? The prince, of course, was hurt. He locked himself up in the workshop of his kingdom and started to tinker with something. And about a week or so later, the princess was playing in the meadow, scaring her ladies in waiting with her jack-in-the-box, and suddenly she heard some music. It was the prince, dressed up as a swineherd, sitting on a tree stump. He was holding a wonderful pot. All around it were little bells, and on top was a lid made of gold. Ding dong, the little bells kept ringing. Oh, you dear Augustin, Augustin, Augustin. Oh my, what is this lovely thing? The princess asked him. This here is a magic pot. I'll show you how it works. Little pot, make food, the prince said. And right away, porridge started to appear in the pot. It smelled so good and looked so tasty that all the pigs from all over the kingdom came running over in the meadow. The princess tasted the porridge and tasted some more. Yummy, yummy. And then she started to fuss. I want this pot. I want this pot. Buy me this magic pot right away. So the ladies-in-waiting asked the prince Swineherd, how much do you want for this pot? It's very expensive. You can't afford it, said the prince. How dare you talk like that, you silly Swineherd. Tell me right now how much it is, or we will shoo all your little piglets away. I'll take 100 flicks on the princess's forehead in exchange for this pot. You impudent Swineherd, cried the ladies-in-waiting. But there was nothing they could do, so the princess had to suffer. The princess returned to her palace, put the magic pot on the table, rubbed her forehead, and said, little pot, make food! The little pot started cooking porridge, and then pigs from all over the kingdom started coming to the palace. They were snorting and trying to get in, and the porridge from the pot just kept spreading and spreading, because if you wanted to turn it off, you had to say, little pot, don't make food. But the prince was the only one who knew this. So the princess and her ladies-in-waiting had to eat this porridge with the pig until the prince swineherd finally took pity on the fussy princess and forgave her. That's what I'm saying! Even the newest, most expensive toys in the world can't transform a pig into a decent human being.
So. Where could all of the cartoons be hiding? Let's start an investigation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's look for cartoons to pick. I will press this microphone. Masha and the